We all know WhatsApp was having a bad time last month, so they updated their terms and privacy policy and it actually impacted many people who were using WhatsApp. So what happened was this privacy policy, as we all know, was not that much clear and people were not able to understand it properly. But one thing was clear that their privacy is gonna be lost because it's gonna be used for serving ads on Facebook. So people thought that their personal conversations, personal chats, everything can be read by WhatsApp and can be transferred to Facebook, and in return they can show advertisements. That means their privacy is broken there. And this was the reason why most people were looking for different alternatives, and not just looking, they started using different alternatives. Telegram and Signal, they started topping the charts and WhatsApp was using their user base. So WhatsApp had to react to the situation, and what they did was they wanted to make sure that the people who are using WhatsApp should be clear that they can't read their personal chats. So for this first step, what they did was they went to Twitter and they made an infographic post stating that we can't read your chats, we can't listen to your conversations, we can't see your video calls. They just wanted to prove that they were good people and they should not be seen in that evil look. So first they put in Twitter, the same post they started posting in Instagram. But then later only they started noticing that most of the people who are using WhatsApp are neither on Twitter nor on Instagram. That means this post did not reach many people they targeted. So then one guy in WhatsApp, he got a brilliant idea. He is like, okay, we'll do one thing. We'll reach each and every WhatsApp customer directly through their phone. And for that, what WhatsApp did was they put a WhatsApp status in each and every WhatsApp user's phone. Now, they saw the status, they saw that you cannot read private messages, you cannot see video calls, you cannot hear your personal phone calls, everything was fine. But then, most people, what they thought was, I have not saved WhatsApp number in my phone. So how did I see this WhatsApp status? So how did WhatsApp came into my phone and put this status and shown it to me? So they were like, if WhatsApp can do this, then they can directly see my conversations, they can directly hear my voice calls, and they can see my video call. So this means WhatsApp is still dangerous, I'll not be using WhatsApp. And then, since WhatsApp's initial idea was to make people forcefully accept this before February 8, if they don't accept, they can leave WhatsApp, they can do whatever they want. If you want to continue using WhatsApp, you have to accept it before February 8. And then they actually shifted, they postponed this date to May 15. So the new deadline was May 15. Now people have started using WhatsApp like how they used to do, and people have started forgetting about this particular privacy policy change because most of them did not agree. Now WhatsApp is like, we are not in a mood to change our privacy policy, but we want to make sure they agree this. So now they are trying a different approach. So from tomorrow, or maybe anytime from today, if you open your WhatsApp, you'll be seeing this new kind of a banner. So in this banner, they have written, we are updating our terms and privacy policy. So tap here to review it. They want to remind people that we are changing this privacy policy. You have to read, you have to accept. It's not like you can escape from us. So they gave this banner. Once you tap this banner, you'll be getting a new page. In this page, first line itself states that we cannot read your personal chats. They're like, we are good people, please trust us. We cannot read your personal messages. But what they can read? It's like the privacy policy, actually, it affects you, not just you, but business accounts also. So that is what they have written. And then they have written that if you chat from your personal account to your business account, then only this kind of data collection is applicable for you. So chatting with businesses is optional for you. And then again, they have given some links for the same privacy policy. If you click continue, on the next page again, you can see WhatsApp has highlighted this privacy policy does not affect your personal conversations. And they have written how it affects your business conversations. They're like, if you chat your business accounts, which is optional, if you chat to them, they can store this data and they can send this data to Facebook in order to provide you good and relevant advertisements. So this is how WhatsApp works, is what they have written there, and you have that agree button right down there. So you can read it again and again, and you have to agree it before May 15th. So this is what they have given as a last deadline. They are not ready to update the terms and privacy policy again, but they are like, we'll make it a little bit clear for the normal people who are using WhatsApp, and you can read this and you can accept. This is what the new terms and privacy policy of WhatsApp is dealing with right now. So if you find this video informative, do subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any other new videos. Until next time, bye bye.